We're at the Layton Criminal Court building where we saw another day of defense testimony in the trial of Jason Van Dyke. And one of the key witnesses we saw today was Yvette Patterson, a woman who crossed paths with Laquan McDonald the day he died. Can you tell us a little bit about her?
Yeah, Patterson was another one of those witnesses that is supposed to be fleshing out the defense case that Laquan McDonald was on a wild rampage in the hours before he was killed by before he encountered police and was killed by Jason Van Dyke. Patterson called police around 2 in the morning to report that that McDonald was in her alleyway as she pulled in when she was coming home from a party. At that time, she called 911 and basically had police talk to McDonald and went up to her house, uneventfully. But obviously, she was scared at the time. She called 911. On the witness stand today, she described the encounter with McDonald as laughing and joking with the young man and not feeling particularly threatened.
Like he said, I'd like to use your car. And she said, no, you can't use my car. And they just kind of joked about it.
Yeah, it was the way she played it off. But again, and today she said, I just called police because I wanted to be safe going into my house. So not exactly, I don't think, the testimony they were expecting to get out of Patterson about this wild rampage.
Right, but we also heard from a pharmacologist who talked about the levels of PCP in Laquan McDonald's system and the effect that might have. He said that at the levels that they found, Laquan McDonald might have suffered from delusions or hallucinations. He also said that males in particular would be prone to aggressiveness, and there was also a comment about feelings of omnipotence, that you can really accomplish anything. Although I think under questioning, he said that there was no feats of superhuman strength, which was an actual point that was made, right?
Yeah, right. The one of the side effects of PCP use, which is an anesthetic, is that you have an increased tolerance for pain and superhuman strength, which I think he hit on 2 or 3 times on cross-examination. You had to concede that McDonald did not pull off any feats of superhuman strength.
And then there was a firearms instructor who he's retired now, but was instructing police officers back when Jason Van Dyke went through training. Talked a little bit about the training he received, including the fact that officers are trained to reload their magazine after they fire, or reload their weapon, I should say. Anything else?
Yeah, I mean, I think he also hit on a few key points, that Chicago police recruits are trained to shoot quickly and until a threat is eliminated. That doesn't necessarily mean that someone is dead, but that they've stopped coming at you or that you're no longer threatened. Largely trying to support the defense contention that this was a justified shooting. He was also sort of, I think, crossed up a bit on the cross-examination when they showed training materials that also showed that a use of force is deadly force is a last resort.
And that's all for today. Testimony resumes next week. Thanks for watching.